Hundreds of mourners have thronged Kololo Independence Grounds for the funeral service of the great economist Keith Muhakanizi despite the early morning drizzle. Right Reverend Everard Mohima, the former bishop of North Chigezi, who was also the guest preacher at the funeral, led the service. Reverend Mohima said that Muhakanizi lived a righteous and integrityful life. He advised mourners to always determine how they live their life because it's what will determine their destiny. He added that Muhakanizi has left a great legacy behind.
Our brother Ben, Brother Keith, has passed on as a victor, like I already indicated, that when we are putting flowers on the coffin, it's not for decoration or anything. We are only saying he is a victor.
The Prime Minister of Uganda, Robin Nabanja, eulogised Muhakanizi as a very hard-working man, result-oriented and an open person.
Keith Muhakanizi as a very hard-working, intelligent, sincere and result-oriented civil servant. Case would call a spade, not a big spoon. The office of the Prime Minister has greatly benefited from his attributes. We promise to sustain his legacy.
Mr. Muhakanizi spearheaded a number of reforms, both in economic and public financial management, which have helped the government to foster economic growth, attract investments, reduce poverty, improve budget transparency, and restore fiscal discipline.
The head of public service and secretary to cabinet, Lucy Nachobe, observed that Muhakanizi had a great record of public service for all the years he served. By the time of his death, Nachobe revealed that the late had seen the iron sheet scandal coming and he kept on warning the ministers.
The ministers are everywhere. They are in stores, they are in procurement, they are in accounts, they are in HR, they are everywhere. So, what do I do? I've come here to report myself. Because if you hear anything, you know that I've disagreed with the ministers today. And he said, I've warned them, these stores are going to cause them problems.
Nachobe added that if it wasn't the untimely death of Muhakanizi, she was optimistic that he was going to organize the office of the Prime Minister. However, he left behind some proposals that the government needs to consider, including restructuring the office of the Prime Minister for proper supervision.
And I thank God that we managed to deliver. I have no doubt that if Kiev had been given more time by God, he was going to organize the office of the Prime Minister and put it to the required standards. So, and I know people at the office of the Prime Minister will miss Keith.
William Bazeo, a public health specialist who was also a great friend to the late, narrated the painful journey Muhakanizi walked since 2018 when he was attacked by a strange disease which was later discovered to be cancer. Some of his former colleagues eulogized him.
Sincere and empathetic person. His outlook and his relationships and interaction with staff, from my observation, was as precisely as I'll put it.
He was extremely, extremely intelligent, very quick on his feet and in the way he thought.
Keith Muhakanizi died at the age of 64. He will be laid to rest tomorrow at his ancestral home in Kabula, Liantonde District. Report compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.